Okay, welcome back to my class. Today we'll discuss a new topic, and that is money creation by the commercial banking system. So firstly, we'll understand what is commercial bank. Commercial bank, all of you are knowing, is an institution which accepts the deposit from the public and granting loan to the public and making investment in order to earn profits. It means just like other business houses, bank is also business entities. It means business houses, just like other business houses, this banking system is also a business house. And the main aim of the banking system is to earn more and more profit. Question arises that how the bank is earning money, how the money creation, how the credit creation is being done by the commercial banks. So that money creation, we'll try to understand today's class. Okay, let us see. Firstly, we'll see what is the meaning of the money creation. Money creation is the process by which the money supply of a country is increased. Money supply means the total circulation of money in the economy at a particular point of time, how the money supply can be increased. Sometimes, let us see, we have seen if the monetary authority of a country, if the government of our country wants to increase the money supply, so they can do so by the commercial banking system. Through the commercial banking system, they will inject the money, they will make the investment into the economy, they will issue the checks. Yeah, and that check will be deposited in the money into the commercial bank, and in that way, let us see, the money will increase, the supply of money will increase. But let us see how this process works. So before this process depends upon certain assumption also. So here, assumptions: the entire commercial banking system is one unit and term as bank. The entire banking system in our country is assumed to be one. So we have assumed the entire banking system of a country is only one unit, and all the receipts and payments of the economy are routed through the banks. The payments and the receipts, all sort of receipts, all kinds of receipts, all kinds of payments which are taking place into the economy are routed through the bank. These are the assumption. Then only this means money creation can be explained, means effectively we can explain clearly. So then the capacity of commercial banks to create money or credit depends upon two factors. And number one is amount of initial deposits, and another one is legal reserve ratio. Here two terms is used. One is amount of initial deposit. Initial deposit means primary deposits. It means the deposits when first time money comes into the bank. That is called the initial deposits. And legal reserve ratio. Here legal reserve ratio, this is also called legal reserve requirements. There is the legal reserve requirements in order to provide the safety and security to the depositors. This legal reserve ratio is being regulated by the central bank of a country. Suppose in India, we have the Reserve Bank of India, and Reserve Bank of India used to regulate all the commercial banks. So what the Reserve Bank of India is doing, they have made the policy of the banking that certain percentage of the deposits of the commercial bank is to be kept either in the central bank or is to be kept in the form of cash with themselves. So some money are being kept by the commercial bank. Let us see, this legal reserve ratio is equal to cash reserve ratio. Cash reserve means certain amount of cash of the deposits is to be kept with the Reserve Bank. And another one is, here is the statutory liquidity ratio, SLR. Statutory liquidity ratio means some part of the deposits are to be kept are to be maintained always in the form of cash, so that whenever the depositors comes to borrow the money, to withdraw the money, then certainly they should get the amount of money. Otherwise, what will happen? Then no money will be available into the bank, and the depositors, they will go without the money. So in order to provide the safety, securities, and the means availability of money, these CRR, NSLR facilities are being provided, or this is the rule made to the and is to be followed by the banking system. So here, this process of the money creation, credit creation, can be explained taking one example. We can take one example. Suppose amount of initial deposits, that is primary deposit, is suppose 1000 rupees. How much? 1000 rupees is the deposits coming into the bank, and legal reserve ratio suppose is the 20%. It means 20% of the money is to be kept in the form of cash reserve. Rest of the money, rest of 80% of the money, is to be invested into be is to be lended by the commercial banks. So let us make the first the balance sheet of a bank. Suppose a bank is there. So balance sheet of a bank. Suppose bank A is there, State Bank of India, it may be A, and certainly let us see liabilities and assets. Liabilities and assets are there. Liabilities of the bank, if the deposits comes, deposits, if suppose 1000 rupees being deposited, this is in the form of rupees, this is also in the form of rupees. 1000 rupees is deposited. I have taken 1000 rupees just to make it simple, but crores and crores of rupees are being deposited into the bank. I have not taken crores of rupees. Suppose we have taken the unit 1000 rupees. Suppose 1000 rupees deposited into the bank, into the commercial bank. So this becomes the liabilities of the bank. That bank can, or bank have to return back whenever the depositors will come and withdraw the money. But what the bank will do? The bank will not keep 1000 rupees into the cash custody, not in the form of cash. But what they will do? They will keep certain percentage. Suppose here we have assumed 20%. So 20% they will keep reserve. Suppose cash reserve, they will keep how much percentage? 20%. So 20% is how much? 1020%, it will be 200 rupees. 200 rupees will be kept as a reserve. The rest of the money will go for loan. And loan, let us see. Loan amount, 80% will go for loan. It means 800 rupees. If you see the balance sheet of this bank, Bank A or a State Bank of India, then what will happen? Here also 1000 rupees, and here also, this is also how much? 1000 rupees. So both sides, let us see, it is how much? 1000 rupees. This is the balance sheet of the Bank A. So first round we have seen, but what will happen? This 800 rupees, whenever the bank is sanctioning the loan, whenever any a customer goes to the commercial bank in order to get the loan, then commercial bank used to open one account against that borrowers. And what the bank is doing? Bank is not giving the cash. What they are doing? They are either giving the checkbook, or the money is credited on his account, or what they are doing, they are giving the check and they are saying, this check you can take it and you can deposit wherever it is needed. So that this 800 rupees check will be given to the customer. So certainly this money will be deposited in another bank, or suppose maybe in the same bank, or maybe in another bank. Then what will be the balance sheet? So this is the first round we have seen. Let us see first round. Here we have taken the first round. deposit is of 1000 rupees and legal reserve ratio 20%. This is how much? 200 rupees. And loan is how much? 800 rupees. This is the first round. Let us see what will happen this second round. Then balance sheet of the bank, another bank, it will, this money will go and this money will be deposited in bank B. Let us see here what will happen. Then liabilities. Liability, here the deposits, 800 will become the deposit. In second round, this 800 rupees will be deposited here, 800 rupees. And this 800 will again become the liability of bank B, because bank B will accept this check. It will be deposited in that bank. Then that bank is liable to make the payments of the customer who has deposited that money in bank B. So it has, let us see, it is the deposit of 800. Again, this bank, what this will do? They will keep 20%. Here, they will keep 20%. 20% of 800, they will keep into the form of, so 20%. It means 160 rupees. 160 rupees, they will keep into the form of reserve. Rest money, 640. And 640 will be granted as loan. Then second round, let us see, if you see the balance sheet, here also 800 and here also, this is also 800. So this is the balance sheet of bank B. Second round, what we have seen? We have seen 160 and here 640. Let us see again this money, this bank B will not keep this 800 rupees in the form of cash, only 20%. Will be kept into the form of cash. Rest of the money will be sanctioned as a loan to the customer whosoever is in need of money. Then 640 is granted as loan. So this, let us see, the asset, it becomes the asset of the bank B. Asset, it is the best asset. Asset means to make the money. It is the asset of the bank. And that bank will earn the money by making the investment. 640 again will go into the market. So let us see in the third round what will happen. Third round. So this round will go on and on. And third round, what will happen? This check may be deposited into the bank C. Suppose you take the balance sheet of C. Then here 640 rupees comes in this bank. And out of 640, the 20%, 640, 20% of 640 we can find out. So 128. So 128 rupees will be kept in the form of cash reserve. And rest of the money, 640 minus 128. So 512. So 512, if you see the balance sheet of this bank, bank C, what is, so here the asset is how much? Liability is 640, asset is also 640. So what happens? Let us see, this round will go, third round we have seen, this 640, then here 128, then we have seen 512. So this fourth round, fifth round, sixth round, this round will go on and again on. This will go continuously into the economy till, let us see, this total money is being exhausted, or this legal reserve ratio becomes equal to 1000. Unless and until it will not become 1000, legal reserve will not become 1000, the process will go on and on. So let us see, we cannot continue. Calculate for long period of time because the time is limited in the examination. So what can you do? You can use one formula. One formula is given that how to calculate the money creation. So money creation, this is also known as credit creation, and this is equal to initial deposits. Initial deposits multiplied by 1 upon LRR. Money creation or credit creation is equal to initial deposit multiplied by 1 upon LLR. Legal reserve ratio, this is 20%. Initial deposit, let us see what is the initial deposits. Initial deposit is how much? 1000 rupees. So this is 1000 rupees. 120%. If you simplify this 1000, then 1 upon 20 into 100, then this will be rupees 5000 rupees. So what will happen? This total money creation, deposit creation will be rupees how much? 5000. What we have seen, initially 1000 rupees came into the bank in the form of deposits, but what happened? We have seen that equivalent to 5000 rupees money is created. So the circulation of money into the economy with 1000 is how much? 5000 rupees. 1000 rupees has created how much amount of the money? 5000. So 5000 is the money supply of a country. So what we have seen, this money creation is the process by which the money supply of a country is increased. The money supply of a country is increased through the money creation, through the credit creation. One, what we have seen, 1000 of the initial deposit has created 5000 rupees as the money supply. So this 5000 rupees, so 80% loan is sanctioned. So 5000, 80%, if you see, then it will be how much? 4000 rupees. So total deposit created is 5000 rupees, total loan sanction is 4000 rupees, and total reserve kept by the commercial bank is 1000 rupees. And this we have seen. If you see the total, this deposit becomes the liabilities, and this loan and the legal reserve ratio, this 1000 and 4000 rupees, this if you add, it will also become 5000, and this is the asset. So for 4000 plus 1000, 5000 rupees, this is the asset of the bank, this is the asset, and this is the liability. So asset and liabilities being created into the commercial bank. What happened? Let us see. Sometimes the government wants to increase the circulation of money supply into the economy. Sometimes they used to decrease the circulation of money. Sometimes is to be decreased, sometimes is to be increased by bringing change into the cash, this legal reserve ratio. So government, you might have seen, sometime this cash reserve ratio is increased, sometime it is decreased. If it is increased, if suppose here it is 20%, if it is increased to 30% or 25%, let us see, if this LLR, if you are taking this legal reserve ratio is 25%, let us see how much money will be created into the economy. So money creation, the formula you are knowing is initial deposit. Initial deposit is how much? 1000 rupees. And this LLR is how much percent? 25%. 1 upon 25%. It means 1000 multiplied by 1 upon 25 into 100. So let us see what happened. This is 4. So 4000. It means if government wants to reduce the money supply, can do so by increasing the legal reserve ratio. What we have seen, the previously the legal reserve ratio was 20%, then total money supply was how much? 5000 rupees. But the legal reserve ratio is increased from 20% to 25%, and the money supply into the economy has decreases to how much rupees? 4000 rupees. Here let us see, the money supply was 5000 rupees. Here the money supply is how much? 4000 rupees. If suppose government wants to increase the money supply, then what the government can do? Let us take, if suppose government wants to increase the money supply, okay, government wants to increase the money supply, then what can be done? Let us see, LLR is 10%. Government reduces the legal reserve ratio. Government said, come on, this Reserve Bank of India or the Central Bank of a country said to the commercial bank that you keep less of the reserve and you create more money into the economy. So from 20% it has reduces to how much percent? 10%. Let us see what will happen. Here 1/10. 1/10 and it will be 100. Then it will be how much? This will be 10,000 rupees. So here what we have seen, the total money creation becomes 10,000 when the legal reserve ratio is decreased. So legal reserve ratio is an instrument with the central bank, with the government, through which the circulation of money, the supply of money, the money held by the public in the form of cash or in the bank deposits is influenced. Sometimes it is increased, sometimes it is decreased. Sometimes in order to increase the circulation of monies, increase the aggregate demand, this legal reserve ratio is decreased. So this money creation by the commercial bank is related with the growth of the country. National income of a country depends upon the money creation. If more and more money created, if the more and more money is coming into the circulation, then certainly the production will increase, consumption will increase, a standard of living of the people will increase, and circulation of money will also increase. Okay, I think the concept of the money creation by the commercial bank is clear to all of you. Okay, thank you.